Hey guys, welcome back to Game Dev Tycoon. I wasn't gonna do this, but I never finished series, so I figured I had to do it finally once. So I'm doing this again, because I never finished it, or really even did much with it, so we're just gonna go back into it. With no projects at the moment, we just have to go straight into it with a new game. We can do sports, obviously, because sports are good. And I'm going to go simulation, because what else would you do for the PC? And we'll call it ultimate. Ultimate sports. It's a lame name, but it's all I can think of right now. And today the TS, an Invento, was released. So let's just forget that, because I don't want to. That seems good, I guess. I mean, unless you wanted to put backstory into a sports game, which makes no sense. So why would you do that in the first place? And you don't need dialogues, you don't need level design, but you need some artificial intelligence. Just forget dialogues. You don't need them. You really don't. And go on, get back to work. Okay. Sounds, yes. Graphics, yes. World design, no. And we'll put basic sounds. Because why not? We have money to spend. Not much money, but we have enough money. So, it's good for me, I guess. Straighten out the bugs. And we'll finish this game. New record in technology, I almost called it design. We got some level ups too. We got level 2 in engine and gameplay, almost level 2 in level design, almost in artificial intelligence, in graphics, and we almost leveled up as well. So that is actually not bad. So let's just release it. Why not? And the first reviews came in for Ultimate Sport. I probably spelled it wrong. A solid 6 by Star Games. Shows potential, informed gamer. 7 from Game Hero, which is pretty good. And a 6. All games. Not bad reviews, but not the best. So, in the first week, we get 4.3, okay? And impressed with our work. We could use skills. Okay, we'll let him know. Eventually. Probably not, but you know. Actually, let's look at them. Where are they? Right there. They're useful tools for extra cash. Small number of research points. Design and tech points. What else? Decide what you want to accept. If you miss, you have to pay money. And we got bright sheet software. No. 1 second. What else do we have? Debug program? Probably not. Well, probably not, yeah. Microsoft Boss on computers? Probably not again. And I don't think we're gonna do any of these. Doesn't seem smart. But Ultimate Sports is doing okay, I guess. Not the greatest, I guess, but it's not the worst you could get. 83rd is not bad. Let's do some research. Let's get a new topic. UFO. What kind of game is a UFO game? Or what's cyberpunk? I don't. We'll go comedy, though. Because I don't know what else would be good and or worth it. Because why would you want to make a UFO game? Is there even a game that's about UFOs? Probably not. Get anything new? Hacking? We'll do hacking as well. You can make something cool probably with hacking. I've So Ultimate Sport is now off the market. Sold 15,000 units. Pretty good, pretty good. And 111,000 in sales. So, profit. Wasn't the worst game we've made. What was that? There's not actually that many bad ones that we've made. We're gonna need Dungeon Explorer too soon. I only made it top scores rank of 93, 65, and 52. So Ultimate Sports is doing the best. So we got hacking now. So let's develop a new game. And I don't know what kind of genre would you want. Would it be like an action hacking game? Adventure, RPG? Strategy. And I don't want to buy the license, so we'll just go with PC again. We'll call it Pro Hacks. Perfect. We'll start dev on that. And while that is going, we will generate a game report, because we are supposed to do that, even though I don't like to do that. So, the analysis of Ultimate Sport is sports and simulation is a great combination. World design, I didn't put any world design, so I don't know why I said that. And simulation on PC is a great combination, which makes sense, I guess. So, strategy game, no story, well, maybe a little stories. I don't know what, I guess. Drop that down. I don't actually know. So the TS just got proven to be a massive success, so them critics don't know what they're talking about. I love the games that come with the TES and playing with a controller. So much more fun than on a keyboard. Well, you know, Nintendo and them, always doing their crazy stuff. Wait, what? Oh, okay. So for strategy, not really. We want good level design. You want a little bit of dialogue. Not much. Strategy game doesn't need it. I don't even know why I put dialogues in. Because it will just be completely pointless. Why would I put dialogues into a game that's a strategy game? You do want sounds though, and you want some good world design, I assume. It's not open world, but, you know, it's, world, I guess. So let's just straighten out the bugs. Get some more design points in there. Yeah, that's nice. Another bug. And we'll finish it then. So we got Pro Hacks, the hacking strategy game. We got new records, 14-14. And let's see if we get any levels. I assume we'll level up because we're so close. We got level design, AI, world design, and, oh, sounds. And I leveled up as well. It's pretty good, I guess. Pro Hacks came in, the new reviews. This is looking good. We get an 8 in Star Games. Good one, good one. Let's look for a 9. 7, enjoyable. Not bad, not bad. Informed gamer. Oh, 9? Yes! 9 game hero. We get it an 8 or a 7. Nice experience, all games. This game, Pro Hacks, is going to be the best game we get so far. I can guarantee it. Is it? Yeah, it is. 8,000? Rank of 12? Man, must have been a slow week if Pro Hacks did that well. I mean, we got 42 fans there. That's good, right? 314? Recent studies suggest that increasing variety of gaming also creates markets for more socialized gaming. More popular with younger gamers for more mature age groups. Make an impact. Yep. Our target research, and I will be right back. Just had to deal with some stuff. So, the engine reminder. Don't forget creating custom game engines to create. Improving your games a lot. You can create custom engines through the action menu once you have researched custom engines. Okay, then. We should probably get on that. Check something. Yeah, okay. So, Pro Hacks. Right, 24th, 26th now. Not bad, probably one of our best. It is our best. Following the mass success of the TES console, there are now rumors circulating that Vina, another Japanese company, is planning to release a home gaming console on their own. Didn't click that right. Okay, well, ProHax is still selling. We have a lot of money in the bank. We have $242,000. $243,000, which is quite good. Should we do some contract? Probably not. Should we research something? What can we do? Should we do target audience? Can we get any new topics? History? Nothing good. Should we go with a custom game engine? No. Forget that. Target audience? Yeah, let's do target audience. ProHax is now off the market. Sold 27,000 copies. Pretty good. And generated 190,000 in sales, which is definitely our best game that we have made. So far, at least. Should we make a sequel? Make a sequel, even though it's not an official sequel, because it's later. Let's just research the target audiences. We successfully researched it. There we go. So let's generate a game report for ProHax. And today, Vina has confirmed recent rumors about the new gaming console, the Master V. I'm not sure what it's supposed to be. The company claims that the Master V is technically superior to the massive successful TES by Nintendo and plans to release it in the coming months. I can't speak. I don't know what the Master V is supposed to be, but, you know, it doesn't really matter. And let's get some more research because of the game report, and I don't... Okay, so the first release analysis, ProHax is complete. So hacking and strategy is a great combination. Figures is kind of makes sense. Dialogue seemed to not be important for this type of game. Good, because I didn't put any in. Wait, did I? I probably did. I can't remember. Which probably sucked. And genre match is on strategy and PC is great. And the audience match, everyone in PC, because I didn't have anything else to do, is good. Which probably makes sense. I mean, I guess. Let's go to game history. Let's go. Should we do Street Defender? No, Street Defender sucked. Should we do Dungeon Explorer 2? What was it? It was a dungeon adventure. Should we do a. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do a dungeon. Let's develop a new game. And we can now specify because we got target audience. So we can be young people or everyone or mature audiences. Picking the right audience for your game is important. Target platform can also play a role. Specific audience. Okay, so we'll call this Dungeon Explorer 2. I guess for everyone. I guess. And it will be the dungeon. Was it an adventure? Make it an RPG this time, though, and we'll do it on. The PC audience. I don't know what any of this means. That makes sense, I guess. I don't beats me what it means. I don't know, and I probably won't find out for like until the end of the game, basically. So that's gonna suck. But let's just okay. So story and quest, yes, obviously. Gameplay. Put the engine down a little bit. Put gameplay up a little bit. Seems good to me. I guess I don't know. What entails a dungeon RPG, but I feel like that's a good idea. We don't really need dialogues. We don't. Oh, we need some AI. We'll put a little bit of dialogues. And level design, we don't need any of. Do we? We'll put some. Because I don't know what level design also entails. I don't know what anything means, like. Yeah. Never mind. Forget that. Forget I even said anything because it was stupid. Do we even need world design? No? Okay, that looks good. Steve O'Connell, a reporter from Planet GG. GG, good game. We've heard a rumor that your company is developing a game for mature words. Would you be willing to give an interview with us? Yes, I would. Great, thank you for your time. Media inquiry. We will publish the interview next week. That's good, because now I think this gives us hype. I think. I don't know. Planet GG has recently published an interview with 306 Games. Good. According to the interview, the company is working on the first targeted audience. That made no sense. At mature players. Cedar, me, owner and CEO of 306 Games, also me. We think that players are looking for more mature content in games, and we are willing to take the risk to give it to them. Good philosophy there. Many industry experts say that sooner or later, games with mature themes will become more common. Curious to see how the market will react. Now we have a tutorial, and we do get hype. She's 16, that's pretty good. Developing a game is not the only recipe for success. It is essential to build hype to ensure the players are excited about your game. In the beginning of your career, hype is mostly generated through random events. Once you gain more experience, you can use marketing and other strategies to generate hype. So, let's just straighten out these bugs. Maybe get a little bit more hype. It's already got 16 hype, which I don't know what that exactly means. I guess I know it's the higher the better, but I don't know if it means anything special. A new record in design. Story and quest level up. Dialogues level up. Let's see. Probably nothing else. Because we already leveled up basically everything. Nope, nothing else. So we released Dungeon Explorer 2. We will see how it works. And today, the new game platform, Master V by Vina, was released. I don't know if it's Vina or Vena. Beats me, but... And the reviews came in, so let's find out. I saw a bunch of tins in there. Oh, wait, no, I didn't. 5, not that great. Star Games has its moments. Have seen better. Informed Gamer. Come on, give us at least... Okay, great combination. Game Hero. Come on. And a 5. Falls a bit short, so... An average of 5. Which I guess isn't bad, but it's... Falls a bit short. All games, this last one. Doesn't matter. It should get some good sales, though, I would assume. Maybe not. Yeah, 4.2. If you know what I mean. Like, 42? Yeah. 1,000 in sales in the first week. Not bad, I guess. And the console, Master V by Vina, has stirred up a market worldwide. That the console is not very well marketed in North America, but it will flourish in other parts of the world, such as Japan. So let's just press OK to that. And while this is working, let's generate a game report for Dungeon Explorer 2. While it places... Where it doesn't even say, because it didn't place. That sucks. I guess I can go to game history and it will say. Okay, where does it say? 100 plus, so it sucked. Dang it. Ultimate Sports. Well, I think that's going to be the last game for this episode, because it's getting pretty long. So, the post-release analysis of Dungeon Explorers 2 is complete, and we got the following results. Dungeon RPGs, great combination. Sound seems to be not very important this type. I put a ton of sound, didn't I? Probably. Platform genre max, match. I said mash again. Gotta stop saying that. RPG and PC is good. Mature is great with PC. Good. And the audience match is mature and dungeon is also great. So, can we research anything? New topic? History, UFO? We'll do history. Just to see if it gets anything new. But it probably won't. And Dungeon Explorer is off the market now. 14,000 units, generating $101,000. I would assume it's dollars, again, in sales. It's not bad. Not bad at all. It's pretty good. Not as good as Pro Hacks, but it's up there. It's not the worst game. And we research history, so let's see if anything new is there. Pirate. Yeah, we'll just do a bunch of research before I end this off, because why not do a bunch of research? You got the points, you spend them. We make more games, get back to work, stop scratching your head, let's go, we don't got much time, even though we have 27 years, roughly, and we research pirate, casual games, do we want to research casual games, let's see new topics, fantasy, we want, no, we want fantasy, it's a great one. And recent market data shows that the Garvador G64 is slowly losing market share against other PC manufacturers. It's an unofficial statement. A G64 employee said the company has been unsuccessful in introducing higher-priced computers to compete against newer and more advanced PCs. Well, it sucks for them, but PC is going to win out. So let's research one more thing, and then we'll end off. We'll see if we get anything. So fantasy, that will help us a lot. We'll make some fantasy games. And do we get anything new? Medieval. We do want medieval as well. So we'll just spend all of our research points on a bunch of new topics for new games, which gets us more money. It's just going to work out great, I assume. And again, get back to work. He stopped working, which sucks. Scratching his head. And let's see. I know I can't research anything, but it probably got something new. It won't let me click. Okay, well, I'm just going to end it there, and I guess I'll see you guys. Well, actually, one second. Today, Nintendo has announced that they will introduce a portable gaming device called Gameling. The device comes with with changeable game cartridges, a monochrome screen on a green background, built-in speakers, and even multiplayer support via connection cable. Compared to PCs and other gaming consoles, the Gameling is underpowered, but given the lower cost and excellent portability, it might find a huge following. It's set to hit shelves next month. So that will end it off right there. I was trying to end it, but that cut me off. So I'll see you guys next time.